Now, he's one of the UK's most acclaimed and funniest performers. The British entertainer began playing the piano before his fourth birthday and began his career as a classical concert pianist. The Triple Threat has performed on the West End in Fame and Greece, but it was his comedy Broken Record audition on Britain's Got Talent that made his star really shine bright. Have a look.
Did you think they would look at me? I'm coming back again, I got a taste for love. Simple way, if you need to know, I answer. Standing, 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 breath away.
That's good!
I still standing. Thank you.
That was one of the smartest things I've seen in a long time. 100% yes.
It's a yes from me.
You are through to the next round.
Wow.
Kev Orkian is in Australia for the Panto Sleeping Beauty, and we are lucky enough to have this superstar on our panel now. Please welcome him to the show,
Thank you.
You're the funniest man in the universe.
You are the heart and soul of Bonnie's Panto. You are just brilliant. You hold it all together. You are so quick as well. You have everyone, even the cast, in stitches. You're just brilliant.
Well, it's because you have fun on stage. So when you're on stage and you're doing what you're doing, and if the cast are with you, you can just have a laugh and a half all the way. All the way. And that's what I do.
You're so funny. We saw on Friday, of course, we did Peter Pan.
Yes, you're a legend as well.
That's what I wanted to hear.
You're a legend.
But you were just so, so funny. And you were able to keep the adults laughing. You had the kids. You had, you know, my son Henry is 4 years old. He was laughing as soon as he said poo-poo. That was...
there you go. That's my talent, that poo-poo.
We need more Panto, don't we, in Australia? It's such a huge British tradition.
What it's like in Britain.
Well, I'll tell you, in Britain, Panto is massive, absolutely massive. Everywhere, every city, every town, every place has a pantomime. It doesn't matter how big or small it is, everyone goes because it's a tradition. It's an over 100-year tradition. Yeah. So when you bring that tradition to Australia and they're like, why are we cheering? Why are we booing? Boo, boo, just boo, boo.
Do you have to cue them much for the it's behind you?
I do, yeah, we do at the beginning.
Yes, I am.
And you do have to do that at the beginning. So you literally go, right, boys and girls, mums and dads, don't forget, boo when the baddie comes out. And in this case, it's Rhonda Birchmore. Boo at her, boo at her. So she comes out, she goes, hello, and they go, boo.
That's great.
It is amazing, and the whole place is lights. I can't describe enough how much you just get them in the palm of your hand. But you started out as a... Well, you're a classical pianist.
I started out as a classical pianist.
How do you go from that into... Because classical pianists aren't renowned for their sense of humour.
No, but the thing was... No, true. But the thing was, it was like 10 hours a day practising on the piano, and it was like my mother would be like, practice, come on, you have to do this, come on. And I was like, oh... And then 5 hours practising, looking at it, 5 hours blindfolded, looking at... No, not even looking at the piano, you know, practice. And it just got to the point where it just got too much for me. Yeah. It really got too much for me. And I just went, I've had enough of this. And ironically, it was in Australia at the Sydney Opera House, and they were doing a big concert, and they said, would you like to get up and play a piece of piano? I said, yeah, I'd love to. So I went up and did a Mozart. When I finished the Mozart, halfway through, because it was all serious, halfway through I went and just did that to the audience, and they all started laughing.
Wow.
And I thought, oh, there's more to this, right? So then I started doing comedy, then I started doing more humour with it, and then I started doing things that only my fingers would make people laugh. So rather than me talking, the fingers do all the comedy,
So the Sydney Opera House was your out-of-town tryout. Mm. Not bad.
There you go.
It's kind of like
not bad, eh?
It's kind of like Shrine, except
hit it high and then went down from there. There you go.
You've shared the stage with some big names. I'm talking Lionel Richie, Dame Edna, Matt Lucas, Sarah Harris.
Oh, yeah.
The biggest legend of them all, to be fair.
You may as well retire.
I'll be honest with you, Matt Lucas, Dame Edna and Lionel Richie didn't actually poke me in the eye, but Sarah Harris did.
Oh, wow. I tried to improvise and give you a wet willy in the naughty
school scene.
I
laughed so hard.
As I licked my finger and tried to stick it in your ear, you spun around and
anyway,
it was
boom, into my ear. And we just couldn't stop laughing.
It was very, very funny. She just went,
oh, I'm so sorry, on stage, and cuddled me. I was like, that's so cool.
Well, it actually makes it sound so innocent. I was just trying to stick my wet finger in your ear.
Where were you actually going?
Well, no, it's been a wet willy before, surely.
Yeah, Hayden.
Now, are you going to perform for us a little later as well?
Sorry?
Are you going to perform for us a little later?
Oh, I can do.
Well?
I can do something on the piano for you.
Yes.
I'll give you, do you know what? We'll go with that and we'll do a version. I do this routine where I do the version of Happy Birthday. Okay, that's been written by other composers.
Oh, that's cute.
Oh, I like
that. And I'll finish off by doing how Andrew Lloyd Webber would have done it.
That sounds brilliant.
And, you know, while we've got you here, do you want to hang around and guest host the show?
I would love to.
Yeah?
I would love to. I would love that.
You are just so fabulous. There are still some tickets available for Sleeping Beauty starring Kev. Unfortunately, my time is up.
No, you should come back. You should do another show.
You're heading to Melbourne as well, which is brilliant, right?
No, we already did that.
Melbourne's done.
That's right, we already did that. You're doing Sydney now. Yeah, we did Melbourne. We've done and dusted that, and that was awesome. We were at the Comedy Theatre, and that went down really, really well. A lot of people, actually, a lot of English people turned up.
Well, because they want their panto.
That's right. And they were like, oh, we're so glad to be here because, you know, we miss it. We miss England and we miss this. So it's great.
Oh, go and see it. It is a hoot. So much fun. On panto.com to get your tickets. Kev, we've got heaps to talk about this morning. We're going to take a very short break and be right back. You're watching Studio 10. Well, he's got a smile on Simon Cowell's face, and we all know that is not easy. Now, Kev Orkian, who's guest hosting the show today, is going to do his darndest to do the same for us. What? Wow.
Ta-da. I just...
That's a piano you have there.
It's a magnificent
instrument.
Thank
you, darling.
What are you going to be doing with it?
Well, I'm going to play it for you. Okay. You wanted this version of Happy Birthday that I do on the piano. Now, when I say I do comedy with the fingers, this is kind of what I do. So I introduce it and say, look, Happy Birthday is a very popular track. Everyone knows it. It goes... And I thought if other composers had written Happy Birthday, how they would have done it. Because I got brought up, with the Mozarts, the Beethovens. Yeah. So, if Mozart had done the version of Happy Birthday, he would have done it like this.
Oh. Yeah. That is amazing.
Then if it was, for example, if it was Beethoven.
Oh my God!
Happy birthday in the moonlight.
Happy birthday, there you go. And then finally, if it was Andrew Lloyd Webber, a composer that's still alive, okay? Right? It'd be like this.